Hello friends, this video on motion in a plane part 9 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Please make sure that you have watched all the videos from part 1 to 8 before going ahead with part 9.
Let us look at another problem related to vectors. The fourth problem asks, find the magnitude and direction of the resultant of two vectors A and B in terms of their magnitudes and angle theta between them. Please try to understand the question very carefully. It says that we have two vectors A and B. Let us suppose this is vector A and this is vector B. So we have to find out the resultant of these two vectors. Let us suppose if the resultant is R, then we have to find out the magnitude and direction of R in terms of the magnitudes of A and B. That means in terms of the magnitudes of A and B and the angle theta between them. So normally while calculating, many of the times we write the magnitudes of A and B as simple A and B instead of writing it within modulus, right? So either we can write it simply as A or B, or if we are writing this vector symbol over it, then we will have to use the modulus. Right. So here we have to represent R, the magnitude of R as well as the direction of R in terms of the magnitude of A, the magnitude of B and the angle theta between them. So let us see how do we do that. Let us suppose these are the two vectors A and B. So we will try to apply the parallelogram law here. We draw this parallelogram. So what will be the resultant of these two vectors? This vector R. So R would be the resultant of A and B. That means R would be nothing but A plus B according to parallelogram law. Now, in order to get the desired solution, here we will make some constructions. We will construct something in this figure. What will we construct? We will draw a perpendicular from this point on this line. From this point, we will draw a perpendicular on this line. So before that, let us suppose this is this point is O, this point is P, and let us say this point is M, right? Similarly, we will draw another perpendicular from this point to this point. Let us extrapolate this. So we will draw another perpendicular from this point to this point. Let us say this point is N and this point is S, right? So these are the two constructions which we made now. Why did we do that? You will understand this later. So we constructed PM, which is perpendicular on OS, and we also constructed SN, which is perpendicular on ON. Now we will start our calculation. So from this figure, we can say that in triangle OSP. In triangle OSP, we can say that OS square is equal to, in the triangle OSN. That is in this triangle, in OSN. Since this is 90 degree, therefore it is a right angle triangle. So by Pythagoras theorem, we can say OS square is equal to SN square plus ON square. What can we write ON here? What is ON? ON is nothing but OP plus PN. Now, what is OP? OP is nothing but vector A. And what is PN? If you see, this is PN, right? So, what is PN? Let us suppose this angle is theta. As we already told, the angle between A and B is theta. So if this angle is theta, this angle will also be theta. Why? Because they are corresponding angles. As these two lines are parallel, so they are corresponding angles. So this angle is theta. Now if this is A and this is theta, so what would be this length PN? When we know that this is again B, if this is B, that means this is also B. So this is B and this is theta. So what would be the component of B along this axis? This would be nothing but B cos theta, right? So this is B cos theta. So here we are talking of the magnitudes of A and B. So ON can be written as A plus B cos theta. Similarly, when we talk of SN, what is SN? SN is this length. So SN would be nothing but B sin theta. So from where are we writing these things? B sin theta, B cos theta. We already studied in the previous slides that when we talk of AX, AX is A cos theta when it comes to any vector A, and AY is nothing but A sin theta. So this is what we have studied in our previous slides in the topic under resolution of vectors. So SN would be nothing but B sin theta. Now we will put these values of ON and SN. So we will get OS square is equal to SN square, that is B square sin square theta, plus ON square, that is A plus B cos theta whole square. So this we can write as B square sin square theta plus A square plus B square cos square theta plus 2AB cos theta. Now this we can again write as A square plus B square, we will take common. We can write sin square theta plus cos square theta plus 2AB cos theta. Now, what is OS? OS is nothing but the vector R. So we can write R square is equal to A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta, because sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. So we can write this. Therefore, the resultant R would be equal to root over A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. So here we have shown that the magnitude of the resultant is represented in terms of the magnitude of vector A, vector B and the angle theta. So half of our job is done. We have represented the magnitude of the resultant vector. Now we are left with the direction. So now we will work on the direction of the resultant vector R. So what will we do about the resultant R? When it comes to resultant R, we can say that SN, which we wrote it as B sin theta, right? We said that SN is equal to B sin theta. We can also write SN as, in this diagram, if we consider that this angle is equal to alpha. If we say that this angle is equal to alpha, then we can write in this triangle that SN will be equal to R sin alpha, because sin alpha will be equal to P by H. If you look at this triangle, what is this triangle? OSN. In triangle OSN, what would be sin alpha? Sin alpha, which is normally equal to perpendicular by hypotenuse, will be equal to SN divided by R, right? So we can write SN is equal to R sin alpha. So from these two equations, we can say that B sin theta is equal to R sin alpha. Or we can say that R by sin theta is equal to B by sin alpha. So this is one relation which we obtain. Now, using a similar logic, we can say that if this angle is beta, how we assumed this angle is alpha, similarly we are assuming if this angle is beta, using a very similar logic which we applied here, we can say that PM would be equal to A sin alpha, which is also equal to B sin beta. Or from this we can say that A by sine beta would be equal to b by sine alpha. So that is the second equation. So from 1 and 2 we can say that, so from 1 and 2 we can say that r by sine theta is equal to b by sine alpha is equal to a by sine beta. So this is a very important relation. This is an important relation when we talk of the direction of the resultant vectors in terms of the angle theta and a and b. So this is normally known as, or this is popularly known as, the law of sines, because it involves the sines of all the angles, sine theta, sine alpha, sine beta. So this is popularly known as the law of sines. Similarly, the one which deals with the magnitude of the resultant vector, since it involves cos theta, so it is popularly known as law of cosine. Thank you. Please visit examfear.com to watch free educational videos, try free online tests, get the best quality study materials, study from the best tutors and mentors, and much more. Thank you once again.